What do you think?
Boys, have at it.
Wow. Cool.
I can't believe it.
Nice.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Yep.
That's nice. Pink spark plug wires.
Oh, wow, pink.
And pink pinstriping.
This was a purpose-built car, so it wasn't built to be gorgeous. I want to make it elegant and beautiful, just as she is. Well, do we want to look at it, or do we want to attack it?
We want to attack it. Let's get it inside.
Let's get it inside.
Right on.
So, Chip, we haven't deconstructed the car yet, but I see you already have your trusty tape out and you're already designing. What are you doing here?
Well, actually, when I looked at the back of this car, it kind of inspired me to think of doing a grill opening that has that same type of shape. If you look at the back, it's a beautiful shape.
Yeah.
But these are just my ideas. Until we talk to Doug, he may say, no, I don't want to change any of that. These are things I would do if it were mine.
Gotta love Chip and his tape. Once the tape comes out, it doesn't stop.
So after doing over 100 builds on Overhauling with Chip, I can see his design brain really, really working hard right now. It's obvious how much Chip loves this car and the design of this car.
And he has the highest respect for the designer of the Daytona, Pete Brock. He's the guy who penned the Corvette Stingray and Carroll Shelby's first paid employee, a true design legend.
Chip's a huge Pete Brock fan, the creator of the Daytona Coupe. And, you know, I think Chip named his son Brock after Pete. So, I mean, I can't even imagine what Chip's got in mind for this.
Right now, I want to leave as much tape as we can on the car. When Doug comes in for our insider meeting, I'd like to show him kind of what I'm thinking and hopefully blend some of our ideas. Let's blow it apart as if we're just taking it apart to paint. So get everything off of it.
Cool.
And we'll have some fun with it.
While we're blasting this thing apart, here's a couple quick facts about the original Daytonas. Only six were built. When they retired from racing, they almost ended up as scrap. In 1965, those cars were almost given away for less than $1,000 a piece. Get this, in 2015, one was sold at auction for, hang on to your racing helmet, $25 million. And it looks like this tribute car has taken a few laps of its own.
This was definitely not a trailer crane. This has spent some time on the track, as evidenced by all of these rock chips in the paint right here. You know, as the car's going around the track, you're kicking up a lot of debris. The other cars are kicking off rocks when you're coming up behind them. It's very pitted right here. Obviously gonna take a little bit of repair work here to get this nice and smooth again.
I think I have the longest nails here. This is as long as they're gonna get, so I'm gonna put them to good use.
Not worth the build until you bleed for it.
This beast of a race car is putting up a fight.
What we thought was gonna be a very simple removal of the nose cone has turned into quite the Pandora's box. You got a whole bunch of different components attached to it. The radiator, the box that the radiator is in, it's got a carbon fiber piece underneath that. There's two gas shocks, so we got a whole nother ball of wax to contend with. Stay tuned, dear viewer. We shall get this car deconstructed. I'm off.
And once again, in true heroic fashion, the superheroes known as the A-Team went to battle with the dark and deadly Daytona and won. A true team effort. Well, minus one.
Taking a little break. Decon's been tough.
This is kind of the Pandora's box of overhauling projects. You didn't quite think it was gonna be this involved when you started it up.
No, this is Marisa's.
Smart-ass lessons, free of charge, courtesy of Chip Foose. Just come on down to the paint shop.
Pandora sold the car.
Just make sure that Chip has had limited sleep, because this is where he does his best work and also has his best comedic material.
A dozen rolls of tape, one laser pointer, and a few thousand flicks of the spray gun. Maurice's Daytona is starting to take shape.
With the body back at the shop, Chip is now ready for his next victim. And this, my friends, is a first.
I have never actually painted a motor pink, but I think it's gonna be really cool because Maritza's favorite color is this pink. I've got a little more of a kind of a magenta, violety pink color, but I think it's gonna look great with the rest of the colors on the car.
Installation can now commence.
You guys ready? Let's do it. Perfect.
Grab 9/16 wrenches and we'll tighten up the back.
The motor and tranny is in, which is a big step. We thought we'd have the suspension in, but it's not back from the powder coater. Waiting on that. There's still a lot of things to get done the next couple days.
Time has a creepy way of just disappearing in the overhauling shop, and poof, it happened again.
See that car? We're giving it back tomorrow.
I think that's pretty bitchin'.
Some of the parts are coming together, and some of the pieces haven't been fabricated. In fact, they only exist in Chip's mind.
We guys are all trying to get the car done. I'm trying to get the hood done so we can get it back on the car. We got wheels and tires out in the driveway. We've got glass to put in it, full interior. We've got a whole lot of work to do.
This has been one for the books. It's an icon reimagined, and right now, we're in the thick of the final thrash. A few tweaks here, a few adjustments there, and before long, we'll be giving Maritza the personalized Daytona she's always dreamed of. And to add to the intensity level, not only will Maritza be seeing the car tomorrow, but Pete Brock, the original designer of the Daytona and one of Chip's design idols, is gonna be on hand to take a sneak peek at Foose's version of his car. So it's double the pressure.
Man, Foose is another masterpiece.
Well, you know, when I saw the opportunity to build this car, I was really excited.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to attack it and change it a whole lot. What I wanted to do is just refine it, because I know this was built as a race car and you only had 90 days to get it done.
I know, there's a lot of compromises made, so there's a lot of improvement that can be made.
Whether it's good or not, I want to hear your opinion.
All right.
All right, fantastic.
You bet, guy.
You want to see it?
Yeah, bet,
let's
do it.
Let's go check it out.
All right. Wow. All right. God, it's looking great. Oh, I'm glad you took the crap off the headlights, man. Boy, I love the side vents on it.
Thank you.
Golly, you know, this is probably one of the toughest cars to work on, and I wouldn't trust it to anybody except Chip. I think he's probably America's best independent automotive designer. I was really, really curious to see what he'd do with it. It looks just beautiful.
Thank you.
Really good.